It's the first official day of competition at the 28th Winter Universiade here in Almaty. We get a look at some of the athletes getting ready for competition. Today, we will go up to alpine skiing from Shimbalak Ski Resort, the women's and men's Super G. And from the Alatau cross-country skiing and biathlon complex, it'll be the women's 5-kilometer individual classic and the men's 10-kilometer individual classic. Women's Super G action from alpine skiing will kick things off here at the 28th Winter Universiade in Almaty. There you get a good look at some of the fans getting ready for this first medal competition here at these games. A little bit breezy up in the mountains, just a little bit south of the city of Almaty. There you see the temperature, -9 at the start, -10 degrees Celsius at the finish, but a clear sunny day for these athletes. There you get a look at the start list for the ladies' Super G. And some of the many volunteers here helping us out. And now Asa Ando from Toyo University in Tokyo. This is her first Super G competition of the season. Her last was a 15th place finish in a Far East Cup race in Baikalsk, Russia. There you get a good look at the relatively good clear conditions. And at the first interval, Ando just over half a second behind our leader, Jaakko Vesina. She carves her way down this Super G course. Get a good look there at what she's seeing down towards the finish line. There's the time to beat from Jaakko Vesina, and Ando just under a second behind. That'll put her in third position. Next up, we'll take a look at Nia Luukko of Finland. She attends the University of Helsinki, as you see there. And she makes her way towards the finish line, also trying to catch Jaakko Vesina. Her best Super G result of the year, 17th at an FIS race in Hemsedal, Norway, back in December. There's the time to beat Luukko. A last push, and that'll put her in second spot, 3/4 of a second behind, and a bit of a fall there as Luukko tried to stop but could not do it before she reached the fences. Appears to be okay. Got a good close-up look of her there. And the work that their legs and knees take trying to get them down this course. And now we'll get a look at that run of Jaakko Vesina. A 24-year-old Russian competed at the Sochi Olympics, her home Olympics, back in 2014. There she was 14th in the Super Combined, 28th in the downhill, and 24th in the Super G. And the leader she's trying to get past, Tereza Kmochova of the Czech Republic. And at the first interval, Jaakko Vesina overtakes the Czech skier. Another part of Jaakko Vesina's story is that she is a deaf skier. Hearing aids do help her hear everything going on around her, but certainly she hopes and has spoken about being an inspiration for other girls to get into the sport. And there you see her time increasing. Now a half second up on Kmochova as Jaakko Vesina nears the finish line. Last many gates there for her to get through, the time 107.21. And Jaakko Vesina nearly a second ahead of that time, putting her in top spot. Good close-up look there at the Russian. And there you have the final results, the first medals here at these 28th Winter University Games. It'll be Jaakko Vesina in first place with gold with a time of 106.25. Nia Lukko of Finland wins their first medal since the 2013 Winter Universiade with a time of 106.95. There you see Jaakko Vesina. And Asa Ando of Japan, just under a second behind. She will take the bronze medal here in the Women's Super G. Cross-country skiing action. The women's individual 5-kilometer classic from the Alatau Cross-Country Skiing and Biathlon Complex just outside of Almaty. This will kick off the cross-country skiing competition here at the 28th Winter Universiade. You see some of the athletes getting ready. You can hear the final countdown in the background, the music playing as these athletes get ready for this opening competition. A very clear, sunny day. You get a look there at the start line. Temperature around -2 degrees. So really nice conditions for these athletes. Good crowd on hand. There you get a look at Shelby Dickey of Canada in bib number 2. And in bib number 26, just up on the podium there, that's Oksana Sieti of Ukraine. And there is the full start list for this 5-kilometer individual classic race. Get a good look there at Yara Thomas of the United States of America. Yep. As her race begins, she would end up 49th today. And there in bib number 1 is Yuan Zhao of China. She'd finish 46th. There a look at Dickey again, the Canadian. She would finish 43rd. Darina Mazur of Ukraine. Got a look at her, she finished 58th. And there in bib number 4 is Li Lei of China. She finished in the top 40 in 37th spot. And there you see just in the distance in bib number 28 as she collapses to the ground, that's Andrée-Anne Théberge of Canada. And she'll be helped off clearly in some discomfort and would not finish the race. There's another shot at Li Lei of China. You see just beautiful sunny conditions here in Almaty. Now the next wave getting ready to go, that's Oksana Glautschik of Russia. And there in bib 41, Angelina Shriga. And there you see Anna Nekevskaya of Russia from Southern Ural State University. And there is number 59, Anna Shevchenko of Kazakhstan, pushing really hard through the main spectator area. She's very familiar with this course. Finished second in an FIS race here back on December 23rd, 2016. And there is number 56, Lilia Vasilyeva of Russia. She won a bronze at Universiade back in 2015 in a time then of 13 minutes, 31.4 seconds. And there the racer now fully in your screen, Shevchenko, still pushing along. And there number 64, Nekayevskaya of Russia. She was 10th in the 5-kilometer freestyle and 21st in the skiathlon of the 2013 Universiade in Trentino, Italy. There again, another good close look at Shevchenko. Not going to catch Vasilieva on this day. As she makes her way through to the finish line. Good time for her, 14 minutes, 23.8 seconds. She had led at the first interval. And now you see Nekaevskaya trying also to catch Vasilieva, but it's not going to happen here today as Vasilieva has laid down a very strong time. Nekaevskaya trying to capture that silver medal, and she'll do it just ahead of Shevchenko of Kazakhstan. And she's still in good form after that hard 5K. And from a few moments ago, you'll see Vasilieva here of Russia coming into the spectator area, and a wonderful time for her, 14 minutes, 8.6 seconds. She wins this gold medal quite handily, over 13 seconds ahead of countrywoman Nekaevskaya. So they will win their Russia's first two medals in cross-country skiing, and the first medal for Kazakhstan at these Almaty Games will end up in the hands of Anna Shevchenko. And there you see the flowers being presented to our gold medalist, Lilia Vasilieva. She still has three races to go here, so she's off to a really good start. Vasilieva wins gold. Nekaevskaya, also of Russia, she will take silver. And then Anna Shevchenko of Kazakhstan wins bronze on home soil. Here is cross-country competition is underway in Almaty at the 28th Winter Universiade. From the Alatau Cross Country Skiing and Biathlon Complex just outside of Almaty, this is the men's 10-kilometer individual classic cross country ski race. Good look there at the work done by the crews to get the track set. And some of the athletes as they prepare for the opening competition in men's cross country ski action. There was bib number 8, Alessandro Carlet of Italy, there in bib number 3, Jordan Cascagnette of Canada. And our first skier of the day, it'll be Kevin Geisen of the United States of America. He'll get us going here on this beautiful sunny day in the mountains just outside of Almaty. Geisen would end up finishing 84th today. There is skier number 10, Nej Stanek of Slovenia. He would end up 86th. They're a really beautiful view of the mountains. These skiers have the chance to look at as they make two laps around this 5-kilometer course. There's number 19, Andreas Weishaupel of Germany. He would end up 56th. Cascagnette of Canada. And there you see him making his way up one of the hills here on this 5-kilometer course. And there's Yupeng Fei Du of China. At one of the intervals, he would finish 78th. And Emanuele Bicis of Italy, his day would finish in 67th spot. There's a close-up of Stanek from Slovenia. He's just coming into that 2.6-kilometer mark, and again, a beautiful view here in the mountains at the Alatau complex. There's Alraun of Germany. And number 8, Carlet, who we saw off the opening. The Italian would wrap up in 72nd spot. One of the Mongolian athletes, there's Amarsana Basansaran. working very hard up one of the hills. That would lead him to a 74th place finish. Now to some of the leaders. That's Alexandre Pouille of France. Attends Université Grenoble Alpes and also competed at the FIS U23 World Ski Championships right here in Almaty back in 2015, where he finished 23rd in the skiathlon. He had a very consistent race here today in Almaty, as he was third throughout every interval. And here he's coming in next to Sergei Malyshev. Keep in mind, this is a staggered start, so these two are competing against the clock and not each other. Malyshev would end up 14th. And for Pouille right now, he comes in second spot and collapses after his heavy work here in the 10-kilometer individual classic. And there is number 88, Dmitry Rostovtsev. He's of Russia, here at the 6.8-kilometer mark. He, too, competed here in Almaty back in February of 2015 at the Under-23 FIS World Ski Championships. Finished third in the skiathlon and eight in the 15-kilometer freestyle. Through the first three intervals here today, he was in first place. But he's not going to catch countryman Valery Gontar here today, trying instead to stay in front of Alexandre Pouille to claim a silver medal. And Rostovtsev will do just that in a time of 25 minutes, 20.9 seconds. And there is Valery Gontar. He is the defending bronze medalist in this event, from Slovakia back in 2015, now looking for gold. He was just behind Rostovtsev in the first three intervals, but overtook him later in the race. And he powers his way through there to a time of 25 minutes, 12 seconds, and just collapses after an outstanding race. So it's bronze for him in 2015, gold here in Almaty at these 28th Winter World University Games. And these athletes just pouring it all out here on this beautiful sunny day in the mountains outside of Almaty. And there you see the two Russians. So it'll be Gontar first, Rostovtsev second, and Alexandre Pouille of France will take home a bronze medal in the men's 10-kilometer individual classic. From Shymbolyk Ski Resort, just outside of Almaty, it's the men's Super G action. There's the gondola bringing the athletes up to the top. At the start, minus 8 degrees Celsius, so a relatively nice day, quite sunny. So good conditions for the athletes here. Defending gold medal champion Michelangelo Tintori of Italy, he's returned here to Almaty to try to claim gold again. And there you see the start list. First up from Russia, this is Simon Efimov. Good push there from him at the start. And quickly into his tuck. Efimov in good control. Again, you see the strain on those knees as they come around the gates, trying to hold the line as tightly as they possibly can. And just 1/100th of a second behind leader Tintori. So he's got time to make up that very minimal margin. Good control there off the jump. And at the second interval, he's lost a little bit of time. Now 27/100ths back. So he's got some work to do here on the bottom part of the course, if he's going to try to edge his way into first place. Good view there of the finish area. And here is Efimov. And no, he lost more time down the final part of the course to end up 74 one-hundredths back. There, a good slow motion close-up of the Russian Efimov. Now back up to the top, an earlier racer. This is Yevgeny Piasek wearing bib number one. Lake Tentori, he was also at Granada, finished ninth in this race. Losing his edge a little bit coming around those turns, see if that costs him much time. Lots of speed here for the Russian, just over the one jump. Past halfway through this race. And he will set the pace for everybody else. There's a good look at that finish area. And Piasek will lay down a time of 1:03.06. So everyone now trying to catch him. There, a great close-up of the concentration as he's looking downhill, trying to keep that line as tight as he can. Now a couple skiers after Piasek. This is the defending champion, Michelangelo Tentori of Italy. Attends the University of Milano Bicocca. And great control from him in the early part of this race. Again, at this point, trying to catch up to Piasek. But down that time, as we mentioned, 1:03.06. And Tentori right now, 11 one-hundredths back. So time to make up that gap. Off the jump, in control. Now to the next interval. There you see the time from Piasek. And Tentori, an outstanding second third of this race. Now 19 one-hundredths ahead. Can he maintain that through the bottom part of the course? And here he comes, and there again, Piasek's time. Tentori aiming for second straight gold. And he will come in 3 one-hundredths ahead of Piasek at this point. Tentori not overly happy with his race at this point, as he did have a wider lead through the midway section. But that disappointment would quickly go away. Michelangelo Tentori, back-to-back gold medalist in the men's Super G. Smile on his face now. Piasek and Efimov, respectively, will win silver and bronze for Russia. And there is the Italian. Back-to-back Super G golds. He'll get his medal later. Here are the flowers. And all smiles at this point. And there you see the three medalists in the men's Super G.